Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I came across this striking 2013 indie movie poster the other day, and I thought it would be a fun project to do in Photoshop. I included a link to a font which is similar to the one used in the poster. I provided a Photoshop template so you could follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. When you first open the file before you download it, you may see just one layer. However, when you download it in Photoshop, you'll see four layers. The top layer is the original poster. Under that is a grainy texture that will add to our poster. Under that is a folder containing the top text and the bottom text. And lastly, the bottom layer is a photo that we'll use for this project that I found on Shutterstock. Sorry I had to add watermarks to it because, unfortunately, I'm not allowed to distribute it to the public without watermarks. But feel free to use your own photo if you'd like. If you'd like to remove the watermarks, open your lasso tool and click the Add to Selection icon. This allows us to make multiple selections on the same layer. Draw around each watermark and go to Edit and Content Aware Fill. Then click OK. Deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. We'll merge the retouched layer with the photo by pressing Ctrl or Command E. Next, we'll separate our subject from its background. Open your Quick Selection tool and click Select Subject. Photoshop instantly makes a selection of the subject. To refine the selection, go to Select. You can either click Select and Mask or Shift-click it to open Refine Edge. Frankly, I generally use Refine Edge because I like it better. It's a personal choice. I did in-depth tutorials on both of them, so if you'd like to watch them, I provided their links as well. Check Smart Radius. This detects smooth and hard edges. Adjust your brush's size by making sure your caps lock key is off and pressing the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the spiky hair. Output it as a layer mask. Next, we'll adjust its contrast. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Levels. For this image, let's make the input shadows level 43 and the input midtones 2.23. Keep in mind, since every photo has its own characteristics of brightness and contrast, feel free to adjust these amounts. We'll make our adjusted subject into a smart object by shift-clicking the subject to make it active as well and clicking Convert to Smart Object. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Gradient Map. Adjustment layers affect all the layers below them in the Layers panel. If we want them to affect just the one layer below them, we need to make it into a clipping mask. To do this, click the clipping mask icon, or you could go to Layer and create clipping mask. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. If your gradient isn't black and white, click the black to white preset. Click the lower left stop, and for its location, type in 26. Click the lower right stop, the color box, and in the hexadecimal field, type in EDE90B. For its location, type in 38. We'll make a new layer below our subject by making it active and control or command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill it with the same yellow color we picked for our gradient. The quickest way to do this is to press I on your keyboard to open the eyedropper tool and click the yellow color on your subject. Our foreground color is now yellow. To fill our empty layer with the foreground color, press Alt or Option plus Delete. We'll make a new layer below the yellow layer by again Control or Command clicking the new layer icon. We'll fill this empty layer with a hot pink color. Click the foreground color, and in the hexadecimal field, type in D607B9. Then, fill the empty layer with the foreground color. We won't see the pink color on our poster yet because the yellow layer is above it. Control or Command click the thumbnail of our subject to select its shape. Make the yellow layer active and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to it. The reason we're seeing pink behind our subject is because the black area of the layer mask is masking out the yellow. A simple rule to remember about layer masks is that white reveals and black conceals the layer next to them. We want to see more yellow behind the spiked hair like we see in the original poster. To do this, Control or Command click the layer mask to select its shape. Go to Select and Transform Selection. At the top, make sure the chain link is active between the transform's width and height. This links them together. In either field, type in 110%. Then press Enter or Return. Open your pencil tool and pencil picker. Pick a soft round or hard round point. Make its size 100 pixels and the hardness 100%. Its opacity is also 100%. Draw over the top of the hair, filling in the expanded selection, and make sure you don't draw over the forehead, neck, and anywhere else on the body. We're just filling in the hair. Delete the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Next, we'll add a grainy texture to our entire poster, similar to the original. Make the texture visible and active. Make a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide the copy and make the original active. Change its blend mode to subtract and reduce its opacity to 50%. Make the texture copy visible and active and change its blend mode to screen. Reduce its opacity to 30%. Make the text layer visible. Next, we'll add the title of the movie. Make the gradient layer active and make a new layer above it. Open your horizontal type tool. The color of the title is the same hot pink as the foreground color. Open your type picker and type in the font I provided, Caveman. Make its size 117 points, the aliasing smooth, and the alignment flush left. Click on your poster and type out the title. If you're customizing it, type out your own title. To adjust its shape and other aspects of it, double-click the large T of the text layer to highlight all of your text. Click this icon to open the character panel, or you could go to Window and Character. For its vertical scale, type in 160%. This stretches out our text vertically. We want to position each line to the right of the one above it. To do this, click the left of the line you want to move and press Alt or Option and the right arrow key on your keyboard. To reposition your entire title, open your Move tool and move it. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.